All right, I think we're back. I'm gonna go play a little bit of Libra of Souls to unwind, and then I'm gonna go back to hunting Walzak again. Jesus, audio troubles. That fucking sucks. Let's play a little bit of Libra of Souls as I was bumbling around a bit earlier. So we've badly progressed from this just a little bit. Changed my weapon to Mitsurugi because he's been the character I've been practicing. Originally a Nightmare Astaroth thing, but I switched to Mitsurugi. I used to play him anyway. I have to put this on. That sucks. Okay, there we go. This is kind of loud, so I do apologize if this will sound kind of weird. Okay, so let's recap. So, I picked up a gold sword and started an evil path. So, I guess the lore of our character is he's a shithead. He's trying to make right, because he grabbed the evil sword. And so far, he's befriended Maxi, and he's kind of doing good, saving people from bandits and shit. So, right now, we are at the point where we met the shady-looking guy named Kong Wang, and which our negotiations have finished. Kong led him back to his tavern, a bustling place where people offering their service negotiated with potential customers. It was there I met a rather eccentric fellow, which we got a defeat through the pool. Check this shit out.
Not much further now. My shop's just over there. My shop, I mean, it's more of a tavern than anything. As I mentioned, I'm what you call a middleman. I connect people who want something done with people. Who can do it. You can say my merchandise is people.
Oh, dang it. It was safe to say I didn't trust him. That he wanted to appraise potential merchandise when he asked for a bodyguard. I am resisting the urge to make a gachi guard right now.
We're not mere pals, but make yourself a
alright. And Mitsurugi's here.
Who have you?
I'm just knocking off his fucking weapon style. Of course, he just asked me for a fight. Why am I not surprised? Jesus, I can't believe OBS gave me trouble like that. I switch audio late. So, note to self: before starting OBS, I might want to switch to the fight. If you hold it down for too long, he blew his pants up.
Battle, fight!
See? I'm so. Gonna get the just frame, damn it. I'm trying. Alright, Mitsurugi likes us. He's my best friend. Oh, okay. At least he likes us. Now we're traveling with him. Fuck yeah. Gotta push that. Still tipping on evil because you took the evil sword. Music in here is so cool. Damn, it's time to get the ball moving. 56 should be good. Across the seas, across the seas to the east, is an island country named Japan, Mitsurugi, what they call a samurai from those parts. So yeah, this is the middle story of Rogue 7, leaving Japan to find Soul Edge because he can't fucking beat a gun. Yeah, see? This is fucking ending where you have to quick time and dodge through those fucking Tanegashima rifles. I never found it. So that was about Tanegashima. Something peculiar happening, and wow. So it's probably another ass fisher. Yeah. Astle fishies? Ass fishes. Alright, Rooks. Let's go. We're having nightmares again? Gonna see the fucking. Oh god, why does he always have fucking nightmares? Oh god, he needs it. Of course, from Yom. We stopped off at the village along the way, hoping to find some information from Yanguang and gather supplies. And she's gonna try to food us or whatever. Turned out to be one of those top people gone mad, so more and more people began acting strangely. The killings resumed and the bodies began to pile up. That's when the trouble started. Had to sneak down here. Gotta take it now, but it used to be the most prosperous town in the area, and now it's present. Huh. Uh-oh. Team, that sounds like a butcher again, but I saved for safety. I'll save the turn back. It's like fucking whoever it is, just depends where you got everything ready, but you still have a fucking heebie-jeebie junkies. It really sucks, man. Oh, it's Grow. It's Gra. Or Grow as the game pronounces it. And Elise is holding back his folks. See if we can turn the tides of the Libra of evil. Oh god. Oh, people are getting sick.
Ow!
A man was running towards us from the direction of the town. He seemed to be terrified.
He's gonna kill me! Help! I don't wanna die!
A dark figure appeared behind a man, moving with preternatural speed. Preternatural speed. Blink of an eye, the figure mercilessly struck down the defenseless man. Fucking rip. And then the dark figure noticed us. Waves of fury and bloodlust sent a sickening chill down my spine. Without hesitation, ready my weapon. Oh fuck. Well, I kinda saw this coming. It was either Halrod's gonna turn malfested or he's gonna fucking get murdered. Something was wrong. Something was very wrong. His eyes glowed like embers, and his face was twisted into a menacing snarl. Blood covered his tattered clothes, barely concealing like bulging muscles, which looked more like a monster than a well-trained fighter. There was no trace of Halrod's calm demeanor and ready smile, but it was, without a doubt, him. His voice was a bestial growl. A mad grin broke across his face as he licked the blood from his weapon. So he just fucking bludgeoned someone in his fucking bow staff. Wait, was Halrod a bow staff? I forget. Yeah, he was wearing a bow staff. Rockin' one. He stared at me for a long moment, and then turned and ran toward Yangguan. The mad Halrod murdered Lace. Still before me. Couldn't believe what I'd just seen. Still in shock, I explained everything to Mitsuruki. Yeah, kinda wanna help him. Any manifested lose all sense of reason, become violent, and attack people. Astral fissures may exude a massive amount of force that will either destroy anyone weak who dares approach it, or turn them into a malfested. It was likely that Halrod has been transformed to a malfested by the astral fissure in Yangguan. Shit. While I stood there lost in thought, a young man feared and approached us. It's Khalid. Oh. It's Halrod's brother.
Excuse me, do you know my brother?
Must have been talking about Halrod. Looking closer, I saw that the young man had the look of a martial artist to him.
My name is Halrod, the murderer Halrod?
He's my brother. You may not have this. He's become something. After a silent prayer, Halrod slowly stood up. From the dinger, come with me. Yeah, I know what the favor is.
Please forgive me for interrupting your journey.
I ask him what happened to Haura. Oh. He had seen something similar during his travels prior. As Fisher. And he got malfested. Fell silent, then how you looked at him, his eyes filled with determination.
I practically worshipped my brother. He was always so noble, kind, and strong. He would help anyone.
He did it.
Without hesitation. That's why I wish to stop him now. I beg you, kill him. End his suffering.
How you said your words no doubt affected his ability to fight. His will remains strong. I'm gonna go with a good guy approach here, trying to tip the scales. Basically, Dolores had grabbed the pocket bad sword and tried to turn it around. Sir Raymart here, which is a bit of an OC. Yeah, he's practically the OC, and this is going to this OC anyway. I'm rambling now. Let's go watch this shit.
I search hard for another magic. Medicine, magic, anything. But every road led to failure, nothing I could do helped.
Not any young man could suffer the same fate as my brother could be back, not back either. How Yu's expression was filled with pain, but his grim acceptance of the situation. Damn it.
There may be a
legendary old man who knew how to resist the scene, so fucking edge master. Oh shit. Shit. Hao Yu's voice trembled slightly when he spoke. Damn, damn. Oh, he has to die. We have to bring him to justice. Decisions. Hao Yu has made up his mind. Now it's my turn. Haoran have fallen victim to manifestation. I had to decide what to do. Well, shit. Attack power. Let's see if we can, like, make a comeback out of it. How you led us into the forest where he said he would find Haoran.
This is where my brother and I used to train.
The forest was easily quiet, eerily quiet. However, I could feel unfriendly eyes following our every move.
You came.
I got a fucking terrible malfested voice. Haoran stepped out from the shadows.
Thirst for blood.
Fuck, sword throat. I can't do that with a fucking sword throat, never mind. Haoran breathed erratically like a possessed beast, and his eyes were filled with an insatiable bloodlust. He was ready to attack at any moment.
Haoran, stop all of this already, please!
I can't, I'm not gonna fucking do the bloodlust first. I was both shocked and sad to see what Haoran had become. I asked how a warrior like him could lose control like this, and he froze. Ooh, grisly. These were the ravings of a madman. This is peculiar. Time to molest the fucking city.
Battle one. Fight.
God damn it. Marina! Got him. I wanted to go for the lethal hit sidestep.
Battle two. Fight.
Oh, these fucking. I should just try my fucking lethal. So weird seeing him do Bato stances with a fucking Damascus sword. But whatever. Hauron laid on the floor defeated. My head dropped and the world spun. I wasn't sure if it was because of the adrenaline or the influence of the astral chaos. I had to decide what I had to do about Hauron. And Braveheart's resolve kind of fucking flickers, but I don't think he's gonna slay this guy. Sharp rap to the head and knocked out him. Despite everything, I couldn't bring myself to kill him. As long as there was some, I had to try to save him. Carrying the unconscious Hauron, we made our way to Hauron's retreat. Oh god. Smash news just came out and I'm seeing and or reading that Virtua Fighter is in, so it's Akira. Fuck yeah.
Your this soul scales. Resonates with the light.
The step towards good. And we did have the body out on. Sure. That's a good one. Now a deal. The road to Ling Sheng Su is long. We should prepare well. This fool could look wild again anymore. Perhaps we should tie him up. How you helped me prepare for the journey ahead. Even Mitsurugi did his part. I left the retreat to find horses. In my head throbbing with pain, I thought about Yangban. Heading to Ling Sheng Su meant giving up on the astral fissure. Suddenly, I heard a voice behind me. And it's fucking Gro. A man dressed in black was standing with striking distance. I hadn't even noticed him approached. Well, fucking Florence Nightingaling his shit. Absolutely. What? Mistake. Sensitive. There's no longer even sweat. How do you plan on traveling to company with a rabid beast? Yours if you agree to meet at a place of my choosing after finishing your task. Fucking edgelord fight incoming. find out. Medicine will only suppress the evil temporarily. It cannot restore this outsider to what he once was. When you have done what you must do, head west to Crow Arena. You'll find a ruined castle that you can see lies there. Oh, come alone. Do you not understand what you want when you seek it? Make haste. With those final words, the man simply vanished. Service of the Angles Recruit Village. There you will find a wide selection of mercenaries you can hire for gold. If you want to a difficult mission, consider hiring the services of a mercenary. Okay. Some side questing. Thomas didn't like, seems to like the brightness. He liked the brightest part.
Blah 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 blah.
I'm feeling words. Thomas didn't seem like the brightest firework in the sky, so Carly came as a surprise to learn he had gotten into trouble again in the Ming Empire. Only kicks are effective and defeat all opponents. Samurai fucking tackle, let's go. The Ming Empire was known far and wide as a center of trade. Once at the height of its wealth and power, it even built a grand fleet that sailed as far as Africa. However, the Empire was now a shadow of its former glory. Its once bustling harbors now lay still and silent.
Get your hands up, you haven't swaddled anything!
Just checking Smash moves and curiosity. Can is Ryu's Echo Fighter. He got fucking Incineroar. It's gonna be for fucking paid DLC in the future. So yeah. Kira's an assist. System Ryu's frame. Oh great. Fucking Lion Cable. Good shit. Your hands up.
You haven't smuggled anything.
I recognize that one. Was that of Thomas the Merchant? Tomas. I kicked him in the balls. Guards found Thomas and began to beat him with the butts of their spears. I had to stop them. God damn it, Thomas. It was then at that point that Thomas had said too much. I'd put the Witcher style on because I'm also studying Geralt, but I'd probably have that as a secondary.
KO!
Level 13 officer.
Fight!
Motherfucker!
KO! That's abusive.
God, the music's so good.
God, Rimrop. It's really silly that the fucking character voices for the CAS guys are still the same from SC4 or 5.
What's a commotion over? Stop right there, criminal scum!
Produced a small bundle and pressed it into my hands. You have enough. I think I gave her 5 money. Poor Thomas. Forgot how much I
was. Oh yeah, I could have actually, in your body.
I could have actually given him the 1500 for it, but this is kind of precious for me. I'm playing safe. Got nutmeg, cardamom, ginger, and turmeric. Yeah. Four. Please give out our fucking soul gauge boxes. Let's focus on the Mitsurugi tree first. Well,
Yorokobe Shonen.
Possibly a merchant who was being assailed by a group of masked ruffians, desperate, he sought my help. Abuse verticals and be careful.
Okay, so it's finally fucking Thomas again getting fucking bodied.
Back in Yagbai, it seemed as though life was beginning to return to normal. The people were finally starting to recover from the tragedy.
Doing?
I heard voices coming from the hallway over that sound like trouble. Man dressed like a merchant came running about minutes later. A slight form and hesitant came. It appeared that this was not the source of any noise.
Please save me!
Just moved to cover behind me as just a masked man stepped out of the alley
and found a weapon for me.
You kind of want to imagine the fucking dubbing in this sounds like fucking, what do you call this? Last Alert. but of course it's not.
Battle one. Fight.
Hold on, I'm just gonna check something here. Alright, sound is fine. I apologize for the possible echoing that may have occurred.
Arena! Arena!
This is Zihan. And led me to a tea house by the waterway. Was it? Jason, not exactly Jason. But he bar was a five. And Zihan sighed and accepted his tea.
Caroline would violence something, actually.
Yeah, call one. Wasn't that the fucking merchant of keeled over? Oh, Silver Tigers, that base gang. I'm trying to feel a surety. Here. Yeah, but real grudge against his pops. They're taking chances. Honestly, I'll play Jixon's sword for us. What did that bring?
Well, thanks again!
Zihan smiled at him. Certainly didn't act like a heir of his powerful crime family. I couldn't help but feel worried about him. Felt the connection between us, at least because of Kongwan, and decided to check up on him. Again, if the opportunity presented itself. Hey. Let's go explore.
Oh, we can go to the fucking Philippines, let's go.
Let's go to this fucking town. Oh, what's the name of this? Village of the Winds, Midnight, Priestess of the Winds. So fucking go to. I still think Talon originated from the fucking Baguio. Let's go.
A warrior stands in your
stands
way.
In your way. Lizard man. Okay. What's our food? Lizardman's gonna be DLC eventually. That's gonna be his fighting style, axe and shield, with a little bit of a fucking acrobatics. This should be interesting because people say that he's gonna be DLC, and yeah, he also did point out before that I did find out that Lizardman's gonna be here.
Fight.
Come on,
pants.
So that's generic Lizard Man. He still has his old Soulcalibur, so I'm kind of gonna miss him having like fucking the not Kratos style. Oh yeah. Spent 810 gold. Let's see. A visited an island whose inhabitants were sent to possess unusual powers. A gentle breed caressed my face as I climbed a hill. At its peak stood Plata, with her beautiful silver hair, a sight to behold.
What?
So the fucking swamp here has the fucking circus leader. Just kill him and he can't bring him up. Let's go. I had heard of an island at home, home to an ancient tribe blessed with special powers. A light breeze accompanied me on the way to their village. As I climbed the hill, I cast my eyes to the top. A young girl was standing there. Her face turned to catch the sun. I called out to her. She replied with a voice as clear as a blue sky. Oh wait, I remember this. Isn't she from like Talib's backstory? Silence lingered in the air to break it. I ask who this last priestess of the nymphs was. She's barely fit to control man. She explained that the mystical abilities of the people faded with each generation, leaving most priestesses of the winds with only a fraction of their ancestors' power. That explains this all of nerves. The girl, however, has been blessed with unprecedented power. She may be the last true priestess of the winds, and so we name her the last. One day the winds from the west brought its terrible portent. And a great affliction befell the last priestess. Now she lies unconscious, wandering on the brink of death. May I ask you, traveler, did you come from the mist? If you know what happened, I beg you to tell me. She can only be talking. One thing, evil seed. I explained everything I knew about it. So it was this girl. Even the elders said they had never seen snow since that they could get off. Plata looked up to the sky, her eyes troubled. After a few moments of thought, she once again dropped her gaze to look at me.
Traveler, my duty here is to quell the dark spirits. Their power grows daily since that portentous day. I must remain, but it's far too dangerous for you to stay here any longer.
Iho, hindi ka na pwede dito.
Oh jeez. It was then I realized the wind had ceased and twisted beings breathed in stagnant air were closing in on us. I readied my weapon to defend Plata.
Plata.
Iho.
Okay, we'll just do that. We just cheese it. We should have been named us guys. Fucked up to just free. Well, I won.
surprisingly strong. And that power? The priest rages around you. Are you somehow connected to the evil seed?
It seems she had learned much about me during the fight. Perhaps in her abilities as a priestess weren't as modest as she thought.
Yet the power that flows through you is still pure. Unstained by good or ill, possibilities will just surround you. And I sense that you are not evil. No, not yet. As I said, we are unable to unwelcome guests at present, but should you come to the salon again, please visit us.
And she bowed deeply, then descended the hill towards her village. Hooray! So you just did some fucking Aswan Slaying. Maybe I could actually squeeze in another Valzak attempt if something fucking salty about earlier. Okay. We still got one more mission here. We'll clear that, I guess. There you go. Episode 2. The Wind Divination Ritual. On my return to the village of the Wind Deity, I once again met Plata, atop the same hill. I was pleased to hear that she remembered me too. Oh god. Oh god, this is gonna be bad. Fuck it. On my way back to the village of the Wind Deity, Plata was standing on top of the hill where I first met her, her eyes closed. She noticed me and walked over with a smile. I asked, what had she been doing? Yeah, she swims.
The same as before, listening to the wind's whispers, seeking news of imbalance and great events. It's part of my training. In a way, to hold my powers as a priestess of the winds.
And the last time we had met, she detected a presence of malevolent spirits. These priestesses must have supernatural abilities. Or in the Philippines had what that's what some people would call Surdai. And sometimes it's actually legit Surdai, or sometimes it's just fucking Juno. Like in the case of college sometimes. Okay, rambling aside, take us to her village, but she has something to ask us first. Apparently, the village is holding a wind divination ritual in 2 days. Plata was to perform a sword dance to honor their gods, but she was feeling nervous. Excuse me?
It is less of a dance and more of a practical demonstration for skills. Our village style is not just for show, after all. However, I can only learn so much by practicing by myself, so I was wondering if we could...
Well, see how this goes. She looked a little flustered and nervous, but if it was just practice, I saw no harm in helping her. And she thinks I'm a good person? Oh god. It's time for some fucking wind shotgun punch. I'd like to fucking figure out Tallem sometime, but yeah. So far the characters I've been picking have been fucking dudes. Mitsurugi, Nightmare, Astaroth.
Battle 1. Fight!
And this is so slippery. This is the only... Yeah, that's a strap for fucking slippers. Clip at her toes.
Damn, they're dope. Hey. When her practice was over, Plata led me to her village.
Finally, I'm starting to feel confident about the ceremony. Thank you so much. The winds must have guided you to me. Can I tell you about my cousin Talon? Did I tell you about my cousin Talon? She had begun practicing the star dance. I wanted to be a good role model.
Oh, yeah? Okay, so she's Talon's cousin. Okay. Or Talon. It's kind of hard for me to switch my pronunciations. Fuck. Thinking of her cousin, a slight smile curved Plata's lips. Alright. Two days later, despite being a rather simplistic affair, the event showed how devoted the villagers were to their faith. Plata walked alone into the center of a ring and the dance began. Her movements were beautiful and graceful, and her sword swung to the air, whipping up a breeze behind her, around her. As her dance ended, she sent the grand fresh wind my direction, which swirled around me before fading into the distance. The ritual ended shortly after. I searched for Plata to say my farewells, but she was nowhere to be seen. I eventually found her on the hilltop where we first met. Aww.
Forgive me.
And her cheeks were wet with tears. Aww. Aww.
She's not strong enough.
Oh my, so that's the intent. Jesus, this reads like fucking terrible fiction again.
But I failed.
Tears rolled her cheeks and she hastily wiped them away.
I want to save you.
I stayed by her side until she regained her composure. The sun had begun to set, slowly turning the hill into a glorious mirage of red and orange. She'll introduce me to Talon. You're gonna fucking sidestep my ass. Jesus Christ. Is there gonna be part 3? Okay, we're done. Ending the expedition. Let's go back to the point of departure because I kind of want to switch to Monster Hunter, but are we gonna just farm in my own time? We're gonna try try again with a fucking bomb run. Let me just save this. Might as well just make a showcase of my fucking creations and then update to Twitch. That's my fucking OC right there for this story. Sharing the same name of the character I made for Fate Grand Order. So we got here fucking Dapper off. We got Bongo from Jetsoft's banger of a game, Bongo. Let's just look at him one by one. Look at a viewing screen. That's Dapper off here with a fucking long coat. He used to have just the best. So I wanted to come like a fucking business suit. Hopefully in the future DLC there is a fucking proper business suit. I just gotta make Monopoly Man Astaroth pretty much. And you got Bongo here. Who's can't be Dazzle. I just can't make his knees fucking swollen enough. Just to match the fucking game sprite. Oh well. Got my first proper creator soul here, Lancelot from Fate Zero and Grand Order. Oh god. Try to match him as well as I can to proper Lancelot I know. Yeah, the helmet doesn't quite work, but it kinda does, so we're good with it. So, yeah. Okay, Hero King and proper Falderon parts. And Nightmare, I think this was Siegfried Screams. And a rubber suit, so you can print, you can just use a decal to resemble the line ridden undersuit he had. They call her the fucking Bumbling weapon blue, I think? Yeah, it's a Bumbling.
Okay.
And. We got fucking Billy Harrington here, rest his soul. I'm actually gonna go to mock battle with him. It's Astaroth style, so you can fucking grapple and wrestle things. Too bad it doesn't have spank commands.
Fight!
You got me, man!
And a stealth thing I put there is the axe weapon. The hammer. I called her to make it look like a fucking Tenga egg. And I don't need to show him that much. It's fucking cat still rock. And it's a Sephiothic color change. And I made a summer John Alter. Which I kind of bullshitted half and half. They got like. I had to mismatch her socks. I had to mismatch the Sung Nina socks to make it blend into the skin color. And use the decal for the left leg, for the right leg. To have her show her that she's wearing a red fucking sock sleeve there. The heels are spot on. The jacket's almost there. She just doesn't have the harnesses. This doesn't have the harnesses for this. Because the jack, this part here, I would like to try this the holster on it. This doesn't look good. It doesn't look right, unfortunately. It's fine. So she took the Mitsurugi style, and there were extra fucking swords you can hang on her, but I would probably do that so she can match up. Oh yeah, I wanted to do something here. Hold on, let's just do that already. Color was that again? 31.99. So I wanted to try something again with the hair. If you could like use like these things. Okay, so beetle horns look like that. So what you want to do is rotate them. Yeah, it's kind of the intent. And then flip them upside down. I wanted to try something if this would like look right, maybe. So I got this, and if I can combobulate them so they. Yeah, something like this, you kind of want them to crisscross. Yeah, something like this, basically. Yeah, it's kind of the idea I had in my head. Now, like I want to flip them. Can't quite flip them. Really want to. You kind of want to come off from the center. kind of like that. That's kind of the idea I had in my head. I also wanted to point outward, like, something like that, but this will kind of have to do. What if I kick that with tables? So. Something like this, I guess. Okay, let's try this. Now we add one more piece to the puzzle here. The beetle horn's kind of like, we kind of want to go for the third bird picture. Let's see. Just open the wiki here. I want to show my reference. I just make it like fucking pull it up. I think we can do something about this. I'm actually highly amused at how I pulled this off. You could actually reverse this, but you want the fucking black leggings to show up. Black guard. You want Sung's Sung-Mina's sock linings to show up, so it looks like fucking stockings, or it kind of looks like skin or whatever the fuck. You can make do with this. No. What you want to do is tweak these, tweak this shit some more. Behind the hair. We'll go backward just a little. Maximum length. How about thickness? Oh yeah, thickness kind of makes a difference. Kind of want to make it like that, I guess. And then you go for the vertical or horizontal rotation so that it fucking splits like so. And then let's see, maybe a little moving in here. You just kind of have to play with the fucking clicking so that. I'm starting to like this a bit more. Previous attempts. I guess actually the texture doesn't quite work. And the hair, of course, since we're using fucking beetle horns, the hair texture doesn't work as well. Try something. feel you want to. You just need a texture that matches hair. Or hair for the most part. Okay. I think we can use this. And then we can angle it. Yeah, so it's like that. Yeah, something like this. Let's see what that turns out. It looks nice, but besides, like, this looks so bullshit. I kind of want to change the texture. I'm not feeling it. This? This would work. So I'm not sure how to quite deal with this. Because I tried to fucking hair bait him. Okay, that should be fine. That's why I kind of wanted to make it thinner. Still gonna be fucking beetle horns just passing off his hair, but at least the front of the head matches, you know. If I make it too thin, it doesn't quite work. So I think like 10 or 15 should do it. If we make it 10 enough, maybe we could just fucking work with that. Change the colors. We're kind of getting there. I'm liking this result. I'm kind of glad I actually did this. Let's have it go up a little bit more. And angle it a little bit more out. Of course, it's gonna be a natural, but it's not your fucking hair. Yeah, I like this. Yeah, I like this. This has changed colors. Yeah. Still not sure about the texture. Let's see. should do it, then kick the size up. Okay, I'm fine with this. I did not mean for the ash. I apologize for that. I'm actually happier with what she looks like. And if she armor breaks, of course. Fight. Get off that. I think you can still B plus K now. I mean, if you're close to the wall, you can do it. Okay, that's a wish you can get out of it. Now that's the one you can fucking... You think you can still do that? Plus K though.
Delicious.
Okay, that makes me happy. That's good. Okay, I'm actually glad I opened the fucking character here. Okay, finish that. Got a Zavitia color edit. Just wanted, I don't know what I was going for here. White top, blue skirt, I guess. Maybe we could just recolor it so that it resembles her fucking old outfit. But it kinda clashes with her way she's dressed now. Okay, let's fuck around. Let's see how it looks. Fuck. Yeah, see, it doesn't quite work. I'm not gonna say it, but I'll have to figure something out for next time. And the other jolter I made, which I'm actually fucking proud of, and made me wanna like fucking wear Geralt. Shoutouts to Mrs. Guntex here, Galactic Teapot. She made her have Geralt's moves, and then stole the idea from the machines. Practically the fucking fire combo is drawn them into Hain. Which is garbled fresh if you think about it. As I was told. Yeah, this was probably one of my prouder creations. Looks nice. My favorite part is figuring out how to do the headpiece here. Just the horn and the Volvo's chin piece turned upside down. could make a John out of this.
Yeah, you know, let's do that.
And before we do that, gonna show the other creations here. SE5 Mitsurugi. Using Killex top and some weak tackles here and there. And ships here with fire decals. I mean, it kind of works. Looks like it looks the part for the most part, and it looks nice. And the last creation I had is Pimp Tsurugi. It's supposed to be Mr. Rugi. Mr. Rugi, rather. So it's made him a fucking Pimp Tsurugi. Alright. Oh yeah, we're gonna share that. I'll put that up on Steam. Let's make a new one. We're just actually changing it. Changing up a bunch of shit here. Hold on. Okay, I think we can actually get rid of one. Get rid of this item here. Okay. I'd make Charger, but eh. I want to look at the sprites around. Well, you can just bullshit with Sophia's. I think you could bullshit this with Sophia's and upgrade up here. Try to make John. Again, I want to switch this into fucking Sunmina, I guess. So you can BS with her. Spear as the flag, but doesn't really work that way. If you had Hild, did you? It would just fucking pass off easy. Hild is the perfect fight style for her. She's not here yet, but maybe she'll be DLC eventually. For now, where's Mina? Where the fuck is Mina? Yeah, we're gonna switch the weapon to... The ambassador looks like a fucking... Keep it the anime pack. Actually, just gonna switch the colors and the hair. Also gonna change the top. And the fucking references for this again. I'd like to make her with a fucking coat, but maybe you could BS it with, I don't know. My color here, blue. Alright, we gotta have to change the gear. Fucking Pro Gear doesn't match perfectly. Now, we're gonna have to get rid of the mantle. And you can still use it. We just change the color. We use the keyboard to a ship here. We're gonna mostly need to change the colors and change the top. We're gonna have to change the skin color and eye color later, as well as the hair. Okay. What I want to find out is what do I use for gloves? Oh wait, I I think I'm using the right fucking gloves now. Sprite somewhere in the background. Yeah, you just have to change the colors for the most part. Yeah. Okay, I think we got this, folks. We do not need the breastplate. We need to get rid of the pimp cult. For the pimp thrills. Now, we will... give her the fucking lightning. Six, that's what we're going for. My eyes are fine. Oh god. We're changing this to... You're changing it to greenish? Wait. Let's see John Archer. I need that as a reference. Getting ideas here. Which one here looks is the fucking not Talib's gear? There is no flat out bikini. Maybe we could use that, but I think the best match would be this. Yeah. So why? Because this is, we're also kind of referencing fucking John Summer, I guess. It's gonna be black, because too true. I did wear black. This one has to be, what is that again? I have to remember the colors. We got the colors from this one already. 6436. Here. Yeah. That's what I like it. This one's gray. That is this, because it's fine. Yeah. Leave the belt as this, because that's kind of how it looks anyway. Just turn it black. Just a little bit darker, so it doesn't blend in as much. Yeah, that's fine. Now, this... let me just remove the pattern and... let's make it darker, sure. This one will turn into, I think that was 0123136. Oh god, oops. Accidental exit. My apologies. It's kind of rough navigating the system with a stick. Yeah. What do we have to say? Good. Many trees are just stones. That's fine. Yeah, that's good. Just get rid of that actually. I will just add it again if I feel. Because right now I'm not feeling the fucking mantle on her. 206. I kind of wish it could go faster here if I could like mouse navigate it, but the system is what it is. Could make the fucking purple a little bit deeper, I guess. Yeah, that should be. I'm gonna do that. I have to go back and faster. Perfect. want to change your shoulder armor, but I don't think shoulder armor is fucking going here. Like, if that was two-sided and more shoulders, that would be nice. This would work. Your second fight shows that. Oh god. Fuck. She has like his fucking mantle on top of that. And it's fine. She's a color of those. Gonna change some background rules later. It's like, I'm afraid of Jalter than this, but I'm not a Jalter.
Fight!
We are also changing the voices. We're still using the femme fatale. That's fine. Also changing the weapons.
お相手いただけますか。それじゃ、お相手いただけますか。お相手それじゃ。私としてくれな。私と戦う。いいこと。私と戦うつもり。私とといいことしちゃう。少し遊んでやる。私覚悟はいい。いい度胸してるじゃないか。いざ尋常に。あなたとお相手いただけます。お相手いただけますか。
お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。お相手いただけますか。
Okay, that's fine. We have to change the color trail here. One green, this one flat out yellow. Getting ideas, not sure if they're aligned nicely. Especially with how the clipping fucking works here and shit. bullshit this is. Oh yeah, that's good. Just stay slow. Just a frame a little bit. What should do?
あら、
It's not luminous. Oh man, the voice doesn't suck. God, fucking bitch shifting this shit is fun. Maybe that should be it. Okay. God, Solaris, you could just come up with BS ways of making your favorite. Hey. Close the stream from here, is that? Oh, actually, we'll be training. Did make a good job. Got a Jalter. Hey, I'm still having Jalter for it, which is better. You can also put it this way. Hey. Okay, while I do aim to close the stream now, let's see. We can host someone. Call 45 is still streaming some kick-ass Game Boy Vania. Oh yeah, we are hosting him. I do again apologize for the stream foibles earlier, and I will make it up for you next time. If I do find time to stream, I will try to stream some Monster Hunter next time. I still want my revenge on Balzac. Fuck that. Not except for that loss earlier. Anyway. Y'all, thank you so much for dropping by. Hope to see you all again next time. Take care, peace, and good luck for today.